What up, bros? I just filmed this intro already, but then my camera kept automatically stopping recording. Anyways, today I am filming a tech haul. I already filmed it last week, and if I seem a bit hyper, it's because I've drank two coffees, because step one to being a YouTuber, drink two coffees so that no one thinks you're depressed and you're like super hyper and happy. And if you don't, people will be like, oh my god, were you feeling alright in your last, sorry, okay. Anyways, I filmed this last week, but I've got a couple of more things since then, and also I've decided not to use that footage or not to edit that footage, because even though I was in a really good mood when I filmed it, and that's great, I turned the brightness down and it was already at dusk because I thought it was too bright, and then I looked at the footage and it looked shockers. So I am filming, and if it looks really overexposed, it's because I haven't turned the brightness down, because I don't want that to happen again. But anyways, I'm going to get straight to it, because otherwise I am going to be filming for about 20 minutes and then I'm going to have to edit all that footage into about 12 minutes. So I'm going to start with the smallest sort of things first, just stuff that is kind of everyday stuff that I need, and then I'll work up gradually to my exciting items. But the first thing is, just from Horseland, I just got these plain ass, boring ass staple bandage, like the padding up the underneath. These were only $15, they're really good. I had my ones for training him for a long time, and I got them because you need to kind of put stable bandages on when they're in a stable or when they are in a yard at an event. And at Lakes and Craters last year, I was literally the only one who hadn't stable bandaged their horse, because I didn't have any stable bandages because I was that new to eventing. So the next thing was my Christmas present from Rebecca. Thank you so much. You're so nice. I actually asked her to get these things for me, so thank you for getting them. They're very practical. So the first thing is this lead rope. I just told her, I'm like, can I have a blue lead rope for Christmas? And she's like, yeah, sure. So I think I'll use this for Charlie. Really, you just can't have enough lead ropes because they break. Well, I have had many a horse that has pulled back and broken my lead ropes, so I always need more lead ropes, especially on the float. Second thing are these brown, very dark brown, like dark Havana brown, Kincaid spur straps. Kincaid leather. Can we appreciate this dog? So yes, I needed these because my spur straps, you know, are kind of getting really, really not that great. They were aging quite badly. So yes, thank you so much for that. They will be great with my new boots, which I'll show you later. So the next thing is another practical item. I got this in a Kris Kringle from Mum, because she got them from a store that was at Kikaudi Horse Trials. If you want to see the Kikaudi Horse Trials Cross Country vlog, it is on my second channel. I have been doing Vlogmas, so if you want to head over and watch my December, it's literally my whole December pretty much. But yeah, I got these MAC magic brushes. They are the real magic brushes, because I have one, but it is very fake, and they're the kind of consistency of the brushes down there. But yeah, I haven't used them yet. Oh yeah, I've used them and put them back in here and like cleaned them perfectly so they look brand new. But yeah, I'll let you know how I get on with these. They're apparently very good. My fake one wasn't that impressed with, so I didn't bother getting real ones, but Mum got real ones for me, so I'll try these and see how they go. Hannah, you need to be more hyper. Okay. So this next thing is from the brilliant brand Pampiano. I got this from my sister because she's heading over to the UK for Christmas, so she won't be around my family, so she gave mine to me early. I actually said on my blog, she looked at my blog post that I did for Pampiano, and she looked at it and she saw the belt that I liked, and I said like, oh yeah, I wrote that belt, but like I didn't order it when they offered me to get one of their belts. And I'm like, I don't know why I didn't order it, but like I just got the other one because it was more of my colour, but now I really want that one. And then my sister, being the very organized and clever person she is, she got me this belt. It is an absolutely stunning belt. I just loved how traditional the colouring was with it. Yeah, of course, Pan Piano there. So pretty. So this is absolutely gorgeous and I will be using it all the time. If you checked my last two Vlogmases, you'll see that I was wearing them in my lessons. So there you go. So with the same sort of theme, I got this from the 3-day event on the one day that I got to go when the stores were actually open, which was so annoying, but I mean, school is cold. Only one time I can go to schoolies without being a toolie, and then 3-day event every single year, so I chose to go to the 3-day event on Thursday and then schoolies Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So anyways, this is what I picked up. The only thing, surprisingly, that I picked up from the 3-day event, Mum put it on Dexter in the paddock and he's already broken it. I don't know how he managed to break it, but it's down here. He's just kind of done that to it, which is a pain in the bum, so I'm gonna have to get that fixed. But this is just absolutely gorgeous and just so me. But yeah, I absolutely love it. It's kind of, it's off, not quite my colour. Like this blue is not quite my colour, but then we've got navy and yellow, and navy is gonna be Dexter's primary colour, I think, just because it's kind of more traditional. Maybe brown and then a little bit of ocean, maybe, if I kind of want to mix their colours a bit. But what I really like is actually the Equiporium. They have this absolutely gorgeous colour and then this gorgeous blue colour and then a trim which is white, and I think that looks stunning, and that's the colour I want for Dexter. So they were, I haven't actually said where it's from, but it's from Southern Stars Saddlery, which is a Western Australian brand, which is gorgeous, and it's got white stitching, just very classic. And I've already got a photo on my Instagram of Jericho in it, even though it is going to be Dexter's show halter. So now we are on the last two things. This one is very, I get a million of these. You have seen me present a million of these to you in my hauls, but this is yet another Lemieux pad. So I got a, when I got my next item that I will show you that is very, very exciting, and I got it for my 18th birthday, I got this Hunter Green dressage saddle blanket from Lemieux, which is stunning. I freaking love it. I haven't used it yet because the tags are still on it. You can probably tell, but I have the bandages for this. So now I just want a Hunter Green polo shirt to go with it, and it will look bloody good. I'm not even Australian. And then it's felt underneath, like probably half the pads. And it's also that sort of, it's not suede, it's that luster fabric that the luster pads have. I'm not actually sure what it is, but it's just like not suede, but a lot less, but a lot kind of tougher. And I actually prefer it than the suede, because the suede can not be that great to wash, like when you fold them, if you have to fold them when you wash them, which you pretty much would have to do all the time. It kind of gets, the suede ones get this build up of all the stuff, like all the dirt and stuff in the washing machine, and it just kind of sticks on there, which is shockers for the white pad. Who's got me saying shockers? I have no idea. I can't stop saying it now, especially in this video. But yeah, that it gets that kind of line down there and you have to hand wash it off, so that's not that great. But that one's should be, that one should go away. But that one should be okay. So get ready for the finale. So my last item I got for my 18th birthday, it was kind of my last ever, like, you know, proper, nice, like expensive, let's say that, present from my parents kinda ever. So went out with a bang and got my new tall boots for show jumping. So these are absolutely stunning. Those who have been on my or see Instagram recently would have seen the photos of these. They are, I have no idea how to pronounce the name and I'm not gonna bother with it, but they are by an Italian boot company. I didn't actually read any reviews before I got these, which is very stupid. Maybe don't ever do that, but I did. And they turned out gorgeous, but I'm really, really, really hoping, because the leather's very soft, that they won't drop anymore, because they've dropped a bit. And let's just say they're on that borderline where it's like, will these become too short for me? Will they look a bit odd when I ride in them because they're a little bit short? But like, I've looked at a lot of photos and usually I have my black tour boots are very, very high on my leg, so I think I've just been looking at them and being like, oh, this is where all boots should be, but really these are just a little bit lower than that, so I'm kind of like, please don't drop anymore. Please, please no. But they're this gorgeous chocolate brown colour. I'm gradually turning all my tack, or I have now turned all my like rider wear for show jumping over to brown, so pretty much all everything I have now is brown for show jumping, which is, yeah, it took so long, but yeah, these are absolutely stunning. I'll show you a couple of close-ups now. If you can read that, I'm not gonna say it because I'm probably gonna get it wrong. Clean as a whistle. But yeah, also why this one looks a bit funkier than this one. Like, this one has a actually blown up like boot thing in it, but this one is, I think it's popped because this one's just not blowing up, so that's annoying. But yeah, these are just the most gorgeous boots. I didn't break them in time for Kikaudi, so I didn't bother using them, but I am definitely going to bring them in the new season and show them off. They are very blingy. I'm a bit worried, in fact, to wear them because it's like, whoa, what are they? How much did they cost? And I'll be like, ah, don't worry. But yeah, they're gorgeous. I got the patent crocodile skin on the top, obviously not real crocodile, but looks gorgeous. And then on the toe as well, and on the heel, I had someone comment on my Instagram post, I love them so much, but ew, the toe looks gross. I'm like, awesome, thanks, awesome. But yeah, I'll give you a show of the nice looking boot. So that's, I'll give you some close-ups here. It's got the horse head logo on there, and then this gorgeous, almost like a wooden look to the heel here. The toe here is just stunning and very bright. And then you can get these without laces, and the laces were not on the shown example of the boot, but I love laces on tour boots, so I got them. Side, if you could stop focusing on me, that would be awesome. And then just really sleek soft leather, and then once again the patent crocodile on the top here. Just shut my computer so you can see it. And that brand there, Sacciari or whatever. And then once again a button with a horse head logo there. Not gonna lie, they are so hard for me to get on, and I've noticed that my right leg is a great deal bigger than my left leg, which is really odd because apparently I'm right-handed, and apparently it's supposed to go like diagonally across your body, like your left leg strong, your right hand strong, but literally it's just my right side is just a lot stronger than my left side, so I'll actually just be like, that's why I'm very off balance. Also too, when I ride, I'm constantly trying to work on being balanced, but my right side is just so much stronger than my left side, and so much more coordinated too, so people will be like, left leg, and I'm like, I can't lose it, I'm so weak. So yeah, that's just me being a weird human being. But yeah, I've been trying to put them on every day just for at least, you know, 10 minutes or so I can expand them. The first couple of times I rode in them, my leg hurt so much, my right leg hurt so much the day after. Absolutely love these. Oh, and I forgot to say, this is the sole, and apparently they have been in conjunction with Vibram. That is the Vibram logo, and I'm assuming they work together to make the boot as comfortable as possible.
Which is really cool, because that's a really nice, significant brand. But anyway, thanks so much for watching this haul. The last time I did it, I actually only had 3 things, so I'm quite glad that I managed to fill it up with a bit more, and I hope you enjoyed. I will hopefully have another one again after Christmas, but I'm not sure on that because I probably won't be getting very much, and as what happened last year, I'll probably receive it in like February or something. So it won't really end up being a Christmas haul, it will probably end up being like a February haul or something. But yeah, hope you enjoyed. I'll see you for my next video. Oh, and for my next video, I'd really like to do a question and answers video. So if you could post any questions that you have for me down below here or on my Ask FM, because if you want to do, in case you want to do it anonymously, which I totally understand, or even on my Tumblr, and use the hashtag Q&A video. I will hopefully be able to film that next week. So see you guys. Bye.